What's up, y'all? All right, so here's the deal. I'm sitting here reading an article about Dave Chappelle's latest stand-up, Sticks and Bones, or Sticks and Stones, or whatever the fuck it's called. Sticks and Stones. And I actually just had a conversation with a friend of mine in the DMs about this special. She found it funny, and I've read most things that say they, folks in the realm of the work that I do who have not found it funny. But here's the thing I want to say about Dave Chappelle, because I think we're giving this homie some passes. The Dave Chappelle just hasn't earned is what's really the case, right? People, you know, this particular thing that I'm reading in Playboy, I actually think is really accurate in the idea that part of what doesn't work about Chappelle's stand-up these days is that there is an expectation that what we used to laugh at, we still laugh at. And that there is a lack of evolution on Chappelle's part. And that a comedian's job is to write what's funny. And my friend said, comedians do this for therapy oftentimes. It's not about you. But I would disagree with that, because if it wasn't about me, you'd be telling jokes by yourself at home like I do. Your girl stay up in here cracking the most jokes alone. Because I'm very clear that there is an expectation that there's a relationship between the comedian and the audience. Otherwise, the comedian doesn't need an audience, right? Otherwise, the comedian would tell jokes to themselves. And so if the audience isn't laughing, then the joke ain't funny, which means you're not delivering on your part of the job. But here's where I think people keep missing the boat about Dave Chappelle, is they keep talking about Dave Chappelle as like one of the foremost thinkers. You know, like he's supposed to be astute as it relates to, you know, political commentary. And what I am just here to offer is that that was true 20 years ago. Dave Chappelle was hilarious a cool 15 years ago, a cool almost two decades ago. He was astute. His analysis was spot on. It was interesting and complex and nuanced. And the problem is that Dave Chappelle stopped growing. He left the Chappelle Show so that he didn't have to cater to the whims of producers and audiences in creating what he wanted to create. And he also decided at that point to totally stagnate. And so what makes Dave Chappelle not funny today is that his analysis is stuck in 2003 and 4 and whenever that show was out. His analysis is in the early 2000s, and everybody else is right now looking at a world of violence and heinous abuse and brutality against the most marginalized people. And most of us are actually like, that's not cool. And Dave Chappelle's like, but it's still funny. And we're like, but it isn't. And so the only things that he actually has analysis about are the same things that he had analysis about 20 years ago. He's always had an analysis about race that ends where his identity ends, that ends at the intersection of his own experiences. And as a rich, cis, able-bodied black man, it ends at blackness, because every other identity is rooted in a position of power and privilege. And so I'm not listening to Dave Chappelle anymore, because the problem is he isn't brilliant. He's dated. Listening to Dave Chappelle would be like popping in a VHS at this point. Like the screen, or being like, you know what? I really feel like listening to this tape on this tape recorder. I'm gonna play my boom box tonight. The reality is he is antiquated. He is dated. He is not evolving as we are evolving. And part of the reason he is not evolving as we are evolving is because when you are a rich, cis, able-bodied, heterosexual man, you don't fucking have to. And there's that.